Lord of the Ages rode one night out through the gateways of time, astride a great charger in a cloak of white samite. He flew on the air like a storm. Dark was the night, for he'd gathered the stars in his hand to light a path through the sky, while the hooves of his charger made comets of fire, bewitching all eyes that beheld them.
Lord of the ages, nobody knows whither he goes. Nobody knows.
Below a dark forest in caves of black granite, the children of darkness dwelled in oblivion, betraying one another in endless confusion, for the Lord of the Dark had bewitched them. From time's first creation, the wise men and prophets and all workers of magic had warned of the reckoning, the wind and the fire and the plague of destruction that follows the path. Far above the wide ocean and thundering rivers, through the sun and the rain and the turn of the seasons, rode the God of all-knowing, while all around him celestial companions, friends from the void before time was woven, honor his crown with words of white fire and carry his robes of light. Valley, a young child was born, filling the night with his crying. And an old man gave thanks to the Lord of the Ages, whose battle is not with innocence. But the birds of the air were silent, knowing the time had come when time was forgotten. The waters were stilled, the mountains stood empty, for the cities were deaf. Long, long ago.
Thank you.
And from the blood and the thunder of men and their dying, his eyes dark with sorrow, the Lord of the ages gathered in his harvest. To the old and helpless, the weak and the humble, to the children of light, his words of compassion breathed on them gently, dissolving the darkness across the great valley that rumbled with fire. And from the death and destruction, the Lord of the ages carried the fruit of the harvest to freedom.